Well, hello, my friends, and happy Sunday to you. So let's go over the supplies real quick, talk about it just kind of a little bit, and then we'll dive right into creating. So look at this cutie that I've done today. I just love it's been such a long time since I've actually worked on an 8x8. This is an 8x8. That's all I did when I first started, and now I only work bigger. And so it was kind of an adjustment. I had to kind of get my bearings back. But I love this. I love the simplicity of it. I love the graphics and the kind of vintagey feel. And I'll talk more about that at the end of the video. But this is what we've created today. So for the backgrounds, I used the teal and the matcha green tea here. And then for the stenciling, over the top of that, the top is the one of the retro patterns. I don't know. It'll be on sale. It'll be listed on the blog. And then the rainbows on the bottom. I just love the kind of graphicness of it, the simplisticness of it. And then of course, the feathers for the feathers. Those are the three stencils that I used in today's project. Those will be on sale this week. Then the supplies. Let's see. Rest of the supplies. So, red deep. I used a tiny bit of this red deep. I didn't use a ton of it. It kind of has an orangey feel to it, which I like. But I used a little bit of that and mixed it with my magenta for my stenciling down here. And then oh yeah, gray. So for this stenciling, I wanted it to be dark, but I didn't want it to be like black. So I mixed some warm gray and some black together. And this is Blick. This is Blick. This is Liquitex, quinacridone magenta, warm gray, and then regular black. And then let's see. Then that's the background. Then I did a little bit of a wash with raw umber, kind of start pushing it back. And I also used my brayer with some gesso, with my Utrecht gesso, to kind of again push that back. And then that was pretty much the background. I put the papers down. This is just a sheet of paper that I had in my stash. I did the leaves, or the leaves, the feathers on regular copy paper, and I mixed together the warm gray, raw umber, and a little bit of this yellow oxide because I wanted it to have a kind of a warmer feel. You can see that yellow oxide in there because I knew I was going to be putting some vintage papers down. So I wanted there to be some warm in there so that they would kind of go together. I wanted the juxtaposition of the graphic and the vintage, but I just still wanted it to kind of blend together. Then vintage paper for this kind of piece, I just printed out my quote. I cut out my leaves. I used a Faber-Castell Pitt pen to just kind of get my words in there. And then I used my charcoal pencil with some scratchy lines. And yeah, that's it. Some scratchy lines here and to kind of shade. And then I added additional shading with a brown and a black soft pastel. And then I added a little bit of additional color, which I'm not exactly sure I'm a fan of yet. It's going to have to sit with me for a second. In some teal, I added some highlights in teal in the leaves, which I love. I added some additional shading with my charcoal pencil on the words and some kind of scratchy lines in here. And then shading around the edge. And that's it. Super easy. I put all my papers down with Liquitex matte gel. And that's all the supplies. Super easy. All the supplies will be listed on the blog, and the link to the blog is down below in the YouTube description box. There'll be additional details and pictures and all that on the blog. And if you enjoyed today's project, I hope you subscribe and like so that you never miss a video. All right, so let's start creating.
Thank you.
Okay, my loves, there she is. This was super fun. It was really, really easy, and that's kind of what I needed this week. And how I got the inspiration for it was so serendipitous. I love it when that happens. I was kind of searching for my inspiration for this Sunday, and it just flew out at me. I had something else planned. Not really sure about it, and then it was just like today. I mean, literally today, I found the quote, and just by thumbing through I think it was a magazine, I don't remember, or I was reading somebody's post on Instagram or something. I don't remember. Anyway, the quote came out at me, and so I love this. I love the graphic and then the vintage, and I love that kind of the opposites kind of thing. And it kind of played into the meaning and the inspiration. So I just kind of started taking some of this. I put some soft pastels out here on the edges, and I'm not really a fan. So I kind of pulled it back. I want to keep it simple. I don't want to complicate it because that's what I love about this piece. I did a lot of things that I don't typically do. I very rarely put something right in the center anymore, but I wanted it to be super simple because that's kind of the message, kind of the gist of the quote to me. Again, all the supplies will be listed on the blog, and the link to the blog will be down below in the YouTube description box. Also, this week, the Gilded Rose, we did the live workshop, and the replay is available in the workshop. It's free. You can sign up for it, and you can head over there and watch the whole thing. There's lessons in there, product descriptions, and I mean it's a full workshop basically. It's just the meat of it was live, and all the videos, there's five videos of the replay, just the replay, in that workshop. So you can head over there and sign up for it. It's free, and have fun and create. And then also this week launched the Mixed Media Insider membership. What a labor of love. I'm super excited about what's happening already inside the group. The comments, the likes, I have a questionnaire in there to help me make it better, and I've gotten those back, and I'm really listening to what everybody wants, and just super excited about it. And so right now the founding member price is happening, so you can head over there. It's only happening for another week, and then the price will go up. So jump on the founding member price because that founding member price will stay with you for as long as you stay subscribed. It won't go up at all. So it's a really, really great deal for let's see, five projects a month, are not projects, but challenges, techniques, journaling, art journaling, and then a real large project. I'm kind of tying everything together, themes, color palettes, playlists, collage elements, quotes library, guest teachers. Oh, some great guest teachers are coming. And so anyway, you can tell I'm super excited about it, and we've got a lot of people signed up, and that is awesome. So head on over to check that out. All those links, to the Gilded Rose free live workshop, and then the Mixed Media Insider membership. All those links will be down below as well. All right, so let's kind of talk about the meaning of this piece. So this, like I said, not this week, but today, I had something else in plan. That's not the right one. And I came across this quote, and it says, "We carry inside us the wonders we seek outside us." And that's by Rumi. And it like stopped me, and I'm like, oh, there's so much meaning there. And of course, I went on a search for the meaning, and one author wrote, "It's easy to think that the grass is greener on the other side, and that our current environment will never be enough to fulfill our dreams. We sometimes think, I know I do. I know for sure. And this is a lot about the comparison game. How we compare ourselves, especially as artists, I know for myself, I'll speak for myself, how I can compare myself to somebody else's skill, to somebody else's social media, to somebody else's, just all kinds of things. I can compare myself all day long. And thinking that I have some place to go to get to happy, to get to being the best that I can be, to get to grace, to get to love, to get to joy, that there's this, that I have to do this thing and then that will happen. And like the grass is greener, like they've got it better, or you know, whatever. And that's not true. That's just not true. Because I know I've talked with other artists and we all feel the same. We all have our insecurities. We all have our doubts. We all have our things. And that quote stopped me because it made me grateful for this very moment. It made me realize, or made me think at least, maybe not fully practice, but it made me stop and go, I have everything I need right now to be happy. I just need to choose it. I have everything I need right now to be a great artist. I just need to do it. I need to decide it. I need to change my mindset so that I think in the positive versus the negative. The old versus the new. Old thoughts, old ways, old patterns, old voices versus the new positive, grace-filled, kind to ourselves voices. And realizing that we have everything that we think that's outside us to make us happy, we have inside us. And so that was kind of, so when I thought about the old and the new, so the vintage and the modern, that's kind of where I took that. That's how, that was kind of the inspiration, the old thoughts to versus the new thoughts. The old way of thinking versus the new way of thinking. The outside versus the inside. That juxtaposition between the two. And how if we can realize right now, right where we are, right with your skills right now, whatever it is, whether we're talking art or whatever you do, or parenting or being a grandparent or whatever it is, right now you have everything you need to be great right now. Right now. That doesn't mean that I'm the best artist. It just means I'm the best right now. That doesn't mean I'm not going to grow and get better and learn new things, but I'm great right now. So I have everything within me to find love and grace and happiness and joy and not think that it's outside there somewhere waiting for me to be or do or find. I have it already. I just need to practice it. And so my feathers say grace, strength, joy. We have that. We have the strength. We just need to act on it. We need to have some courage to do some things, to make a step, to believe it, to start here first. And then move forward to change that old voice, that old program into new, and realize you have everything here within you that you need to be happy, to be joyful. Just need to choose it. It was so refreshing. I love it when that happens. It's when it happens, I know right away that this is what I have to use. This is what I have to do. I have to create this. So my friend, I want you to remember that we carry inside us the wonders we seek outside us. You carry inside you the wonders. Last week I did the piece about wonder, and it's this unexpected delight in something. The wonders we seek outside us. It's not outside us that will give us that. It's the inside stuff that we tell ourselves, that we believe, that we practice, that we do. And that's it. That's my simple message for today. All right, my loves. I hope your Sunday is restful and peaceful. I hope you check out the Mixed Media Insider membership and the Gilded Rose free workshop. But seriously, I hope that your Sunday is restful and peaceful. And I hope that you know how wonderful and wondrous you are. Your wonders are inside you. They're not out here. They're not out there. They're inside you. And you can choose courage and joy and happiness with what you have. All right, my loves, have a wonderful Sunday. And always, always know that you are wonderful.